Okay, hello. My name is Rob Thurston, and this is yet another entry into the teaching video logs that I've established on my YouTube site. Today we have a speech. We're going to practice giving speeches today. I explained to the class speech writing, speech giving is a unique niche that they can fill. If you have that talent and you have that ability to speak in front of other people and you can become comfortable with it, it's a very useful skill to have because, and I probably shouldn't preface the introduction to speech giving with this piece of information, but I mentioned yesterday that speech giving is one of the most feared things that people have to do. It's right there next to going to the dentist in order of things that scare people in life, public speech giving. So I'm trying to stress the importance of this skill. You know, you make presentations to coworkers and colleagues. It's of equal importance, I think, to writing well in the workplace. So, you know, I'm trying to teach some skills again that they can take out into the real world and use to better their lives, make more money, have a level of personal success. And so, speech writing is a niche that they can fill. Most people do not rush to be the person who speaks or presents. Generally speaking, those people are generally thought of in terms that are, you know, that's, you're always trying to find something to differentiate yourself from other workers, from other people. You can do something that they can't. Well, what is there to do that they can't do or don't want to do? So speech giving is a niche that they can fill. It's a way that they can show value to their employer. It's a way they can make themselves maybe indispensable to the employer when, you know, the employers are looking to cut people that don't really contribute in any meaningful way. So everybody should have some skill that other people can't do, is what I tried to explain to them. So today, our speech writing is where we should start out with some brainstorming activities that we did yesterday to try to figure out what it is that they are good at or that they have some practice with. And it's a little harder here. People here are focused, have been focused on not subsistence living, but, you know, they don't generally have a lot of disposable income to take piano lessons, to take ceramics or pottery lessons. Ceramics and so anyway, it may be a little more difficult to find something that they have a history with. I asked them yesterday, I mentioned I played piano, and asked them if any of them played an instrument, and not a single person plays an instrument, so I'm not sure how well this will go over. Skills, of course, comes to worst. They have the skill of speaking English or developing that skill, and they have been for some time. This could turn into a discussion about just improving your English skills. That may be all they worry about. If that's the case, that's okay. So I'm asking them to go through a series of steps to write and give their speech. First of all, they're going to come back with their ideas for the speech, and then we're going to brainstorm those and put them up here on the board. Hopefully this will be full of ideas. And then they're going to try to get as many possible ideas. They have a model for another speech that was given in their books that they have. I'm going to ask them to write out their speech, kind of mimicking the model, imitating the model. Then when they finish, they're going to do some peer editing. they'll have their neighbor look at the speech. Does this, you know, and also this has a writing component to it for today, so they'll be asked to peer edit grammar, correct word usage, capitalization, punctuation. After they do that, they'll give them back to each other. Then they'll practice their speeches with each other for time. Each speech should be between 1 minute and 45 seconds and 2 minutes. If their speech falls outside of those two ranges, then I will deduct points accordingly. And then they'll practice their speeches with each other. They'll be able to use a note card, and the note card can only have 35 letters at the most. It's just a prompter. I don't want them to read from the card. I want them to get used to having people looking at you, being comfortable in your own skin, and making eye contact with each group, each person. Good public speakers, they look one person, look the next. They change, you know, they go from this side to this side to this side. And then, hang on a second. And they change from side to side, yeah. So, you know, they're going to have note cards. And these are the things I want them to do. I want them to stand still, project their voice loudly. Listeners must ask two questions afterwards. So there's also a listening component to this. After they give their speech, I'll ask a student to tell me, okay, what did he say about this? And then I may ask another student. I may say, okay, she gave the speech. This student asked a question. What was the question the student asked? Or what was the answer the speaker gave? To the audience, what was the answer the speaker gave? So it has a listening component. So it has a writing, reading, speaking, and listening component. All four of those are covered today. Reading, writing, speaking, listening. And this will be interesting. I've always been interested in speech writing, speech giving. Very unique and useful skill. And so let's see what happens today. Thank you very much.